Jesus.
Praise to the Lamb of God.
Yes.
Praise to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Hallelujah.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ. Today, we want to talk about something unique happening in the world.
Yeah.
Approximately 2 million people are traveling to place called Mecca, and then they are practicing something Muhammad did.
Yeah.
So we want to talk about event of Hajj, what people do, and then we want to talk about the shirk takes place in this Hajj. Upon this year, approximately 2 million people are in Mecca. From England, to travel to Mecca costs minimum over £5,000.
A lot of money.
Hotel, flying there, spending time, and paying lots of money to practice one of the pillars of Islam.
Yeah.
Muslims are required to do Hajj minimum once in their lifetime. Okay? If they spend approximately £5,000 to invest in Hajj, we see some unique things happens in Hajj. For example, every year, people get killed while they stone the devil.
Yeah, that's a bit strange. So part of doing Hajj, you end up, and it's supposed to be bringing you close to Allah, but you wind up being killed. That's a bit strange.
But the question is, why the devil is taking place and staying in the house of Allah? Kaaba, that blood cube shape,
is
the place where people come close to Allah.
Yeah.
It is identified as the house of Allah. It is the right hand of Allah, but people stone the devil. Why devil is in the house of Allah? That is different question. But as they stone the devil, we see hundreds of people get killed every year.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
In 1919, 1,426 people had been killed.
Yeah.
In 2015, 4,173 people killed while they were stoning the devil in Mecca, in Kaaba. So there are a lot of people are dying. But something unique happens in Mecca, in Hajj, during the Hajj. They go and then they kiss something.
Yeah, so they go to Hajj and they kiss this stone. Now this is very interesting.
What did you say?
They kiss a stone.
So they don't kiss their family, their wife or their husband. They don't kiss the hand of, I don't know, something who is highest scholar. They don't kiss like, oh, their lovely dogs, but they kiss a stone.
They kiss a stone. Okay. Wow. Okay. So we want to understand this. Why is it Muslims kiss the stone? Now, according to their sources, they'll say that when they kiss the stone, okay, it removes away sin. Is that correct, Atul?
Yeah, but before that,
yes.
So I am shocked and surprised Muslims are kissing a stone.
Yes.
A stone, not an alive object. I kiss my dogs. I kiss my friends, but I don't kiss a stone.
Yeah,
it is something Muslims are.
Do you know the reason why?
Why Muslims are?
Why do Muslims kiss stones?
So let's see what people said about kissing the stone.
Okay, listen.
Do Muslims fall in love with a stone, or what's happening? Because kissing is the sign of love.
It sounds romantic. It's like they have this.
I don't know how they kiss. I cannot comment if it's romantic or not, but let me read it for you. Umar came near to the black stone and kissed it and said, "No doubt, I know that you are a stone and can neither benefit anyone or harm anyone. Had I not seen Allah's apostle kissing you, I would have not kissed you.
That's interesting.
People are saying.
Well, bubble. Yeah.
People are saying. Yeah, yeah. Kissing stone.
Why are you standing on that side? Why come stand here? Come stand here. Come stand here.
Not right. Kissing the stone. There is something wrong.
But if I was you, I wouldn't. Because you not look very good here.
If you wish, are you fine?
No, I would advise you not to.
Mohammed kissed the stone.
Just
now
listen, answer the question.
About the kissing the black stone or not?
If you allow me.
Okay, answer.
Yahya, sir, topic is kissing the black stone. If you are going to talk about it, it is fine. If you are not going to talk about it, later.
Okay.
Okay, so why do you kiss the stone?
And give your reference from the Bible. Will you allow me to finish what I'm saying?
We want you to answer the question. Sahid? Is it Sahid or Yahya? Which one is it?
Look.
So,
Bible doesn't talk about black stone. Bible doesn't tell me go to Hajj and kiss the black stone. Therefore, black stone is in the Bible only adultery.
I don't listen to you.
Do not worship idols.
No idols,
do
no kissing
not
idols.
Worship idols.
Yes.
Do not worship stones.
Yes.
That is the only thing Bible will tell you. So, the question is.
Umar said,
you're not listening.
I know. You are a stone.
Only a stone.
So you can either benefit anyone or harm anyone. Had I not seen Muhammad,
Messenger of Allah,
kiss you, I wouldn't kiss you.
Right.
Umar, follower of Muhammad.
We don't worship
Muhammad are kissing the stone because Muhammad did.
Right.
So, now let's see.
Yes.
Why
did Muhammad kiss it? Yes.
I know from the Islamic tradition, worshipping the stones was a pagan practice. That's what pagans did. Can you read it?
Okay, so, narrated. Wait, we're going to read it first. Narrated Abu Raja al-Utardi. We used to worship stones. And when we found a better stone than the first one, we would throw the first one and take the latter. But if we could not get a stone, they would collect some earth, that's soil, and then bring a sheep and milk that sheep over it and perform the tawaf, which is circumventing, yeah? Around it. When the Prophet sent with Allah's message, I was a boy working as a shepherd of my family camels.
Bless you and shine his face on you. May my God.
Extend your vocabulary. Extend your vocabulary. There's more words than filthy liar. There's more words. Yes. Okay. So, let's continue reading. Let's ignore that. Let's go. When the Prophet sent with Allah's message, I was a boy working as a shepherd of my family's camels. When we heard the news about the appearance of the Prophet, we ran to the fire. So clearly here, we find these people, these are pagans, yes?
Pagans worshipping the stones.
Worship the black stone.
If you listen, we're going to explain it.
Pagans worshipping the stones, and then when they find better stone, they were worshipping the new stone.
Right.
When they find the new stone, they were worshipping the new one.
Right. And when they couldn't find stone, what did they do? They found some dirt, and then they started to circumvent, they started to run around the dirt. So they really had an enjoyment of worshipping dirt and stone. Why?
So,
why?
As pagans were worshipping the black stone,
yes.
We know people did not want to worship the stones at the time of Muhammad.
Yes.
So, let's read it something.
Your message, nobody's listening.
Omar bin Khattab addressed the corner of black stone saying, by Allah,
yes.
By Allah, I know that you are a stone. You could not benefit you, blah, blah.
Yes. this?
I would never touch you. And
we ask you not to stand up here. We ask you nicely. We ask you respectfully.
If Muslims are worshipping and kissing the black stone, which is the sign of adoration.
Yes.
Let's see how this is identified as the shirk.
Did he go to people?
Shirk is partnering something with Allah, giving the attributes of Allah to any other beings as well.
Yes.
So now let's see how come black stone takes the attributes of Allah on itself.
That's a good question. That's a good question. We're gonna look at
Black stone. I give you.
Do you know the question?
Would you?
I am talking about the black stone.
Black stone.
2 million people go to Mecca and kiss it.
Yeah.
I am talking about the.
Let's ask the girl with the pink trainers on. Oh, you're gonna run off. Oh, he's running. Don't run.
Black stone of the Bible.
Okay. So which one are you reading?
The Bible. You don't want to listen.
Let's see.
You don't want to listen.
Let's see. How the touching the black stone.
You don't want to listen.
Wait.
You don't want to listen.
Wait.
Wait a 10 minutes.
No.
You don't
want
to listen. Touching the black stone. Upon your sins.
How? We want to know how.
God alone.
Exactly.
Can I give you?
The scripture teaches the same thing. It is God who forgives sins.
Yes.
It is God who atoned for the sins.
Yes.
Yet, because the Islamic tradition, and then we see it is a stone.
Yes.
Who atones for your sins.
So a stone can atone for your sins. Is that correct, my friend? Can a stone atone for your sins? Okay, we want Muslims who want to answer questions. We don't want Muslims who ignore our questions and go off to somewhere else.
Can I answer you?
Can a stone atone for your sins?
Will you allow me? Will you allow me?
Wait, hold on. Hold. We asked a question about the Quran and about the Hadiths. And he wants to go and talk about the Bible. I'm saying first deal with your own source, and then we'll move forward.
You're talking about black stone.
You're not serious, Muslim.
And I'm ready to answer you.
You are not serious.
Black stone.
So, let's read
it's a black
the
stone, but you don't want
let's
even to hear. You are ignoring me.
Should we read the hadith?
You are more than a liar and deceiver.
So which one is it?
Hatun.
Okay, so I read up. All right. Listen now. Ibn Ubaid bin Umar narrated from his father. Ibn Umar was clinging on the two corners in a manner that I had not seen any of the companions of the Prophet doing. So I said, "Oh, Abu Abdurrahman, you are clinging on the two corners in a manner that I have not seen any other companions of the Prophet clinging." So he said, "I do it because I heard the Messenger of Allah saying, touching them atones for sins. And I heard him saying, whoever performs tawaf around this house 7 times and he keeps track of it, then it is as if he freed a slave." I keep reading. Yeah, okay. Okay. By Allah, Allah will raise it on the day of resurrection with 2 eyes by which it sees and a tongue that it speaks with, testifying to whoever touched it in truth. So he says, touching them, the Muhammad, the question is this, Muhammad says, touching the stones or touching them atones for sin. Is that true? Is touching a stone, does it atone for your sins?
No.
But that's what Muhammad says. So you disagree with Muhammad?
Muhammad says, touching them atone for your sins. Muhammad also says, by Allah, I will raise it on the day of resurrection with 2 eyes by which Hajj, it says an account that speaks of it and testifies whoever touched it. People go to Mecca, people go to Hajj, they touch the black stone, they kiss the black stone, and black stone on the day of judgment is going to intercede for those who
Yes.
A black stone.
Forget about it. He doesn't care.
Going to appear with two eyes, and black stone is going to intercede for those who touched it.
Yes. So we've got a Muslim who disagrees with this. He disagrees. No, you disagree with Muhammad. Okay, go on. What do you play?
This is symbolic language. Okay, not everything is literal like that.
Bro.
Your point is, no pagans worship the black stone. No pagans refer to it as a god.
That's not my point.
Who said that was our point?
My point is, black stone is going to testify for those whom touched it. For black stone to testify.
Listen. You have to remember.
Who are those people?
Wait.
What did you say?
Also.
2 million people touch the black stone. Black stone must remember that.
Yes.
And until the day of resurrection,
right,
billions of people are going to touch the black stone.
Yep.
Black stone must remember who touched them.
Yes.
And black stone must be conscious.
Can you?
Yeah, go on.
Can you please be with Umar? What did Umar say about the black stone?
Yes.
What did Umar?
To testify and identify all those individuals.
You're being like him now.
Shows us Allah's knowledge and mind is not good enough to remember.
What did Umar? What did Umar say about the black stone?
Now also the black stone.
That contradicted everything you said.
So Umar said about black stone, I wouldn't do it. I am doing it because Muhammad did it.
Did he say? Right. He said you're only a stone.
Right.
He didn't say it has a conscience. That proves
Baba,
to us.
Do you know?
Contradicts Umar's statement.
Okay.
Umar's statement of Bukhari is stronger.
What's your name? Mashu. Sir, can you help me out? If Blackstone is going to intercede,
I don't believe it does.
According to Hadith.
Something. Hadith. Some Hadith are weak and wrong, and some are strong. We have to.
Give me your reason. Give me your reason.
Because Umar in Bukhari.
Brother.
It comes from Umar again. That is another Hadith.
It's Umar saying this. You see, you're not listening.
So Umar is contradicting himself.
Condemn this.
So Umar is saying this. You're not Sunni.
Now Umar is saying, touching the black stone, for those who touch the black stone is going to atone for your sin.
That's what Umar is saying. Do you understand?
Bro,
brother, you've got to engage with what we're saying. You've got to allow your mind to actually reflect on what we're saying. So Umar is making this statement, okay? Right? And so you've got to understand what he's trying to say here. Sorry?
It's a contradiction.
So you're saying he's contradicting himself. Right. So Umar is contradicting himself.
Come on.
How is Umar? How can Umar contradict himself?
We are the follower of Prophet Muhammad. We are the follower of Jesus, peace upon him. We are the follower of all the prophets and messenger of God.
Okay. Kissing the stone.
that you read?
Isn't it shame?
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Wallahi
al-Khan! Isn't it shame that those 50 Muslims
No, brother, no!
Shame and
shame on the Muslims!
Shame and shame!
Shame! Should we just continue? Yeah. If we allow it, if we don't act up, we're going on. Don't.
They'll just stay here. Suddenly, hundreds of Muslims comes and then shoves us Allah Al Akbar. Allah Al Akbar. Shame on Allah.
Shame on Allah.
Shame on Muhammad.
Shame on Islam.
Shame. It is Islam.
Destroys your mind. Okay. Yes.
So,
yes.
2 million Muslims are kissing the flagstone. Can we just look at those Muslims?
Hey, pull.
Let's look at the
Muslims.
Pull.
Film them.
Not to the human being, but to the storm.
Right.
To the storm.
Right.
That is Sheikh Muslim.
Right.
This week, 2 million Muslims are committing Sheikh. 2 million Muslims are committing Sheikh.
Kissing the black stone.
I did.
How many Muslims are going to be doing shirk?
I did it.
How many Muslims? I believe that the shirk and the black stone had the power to be able to atone for your sins. My friend, this is idolatry. This is, my friend, shirk. My friend, you are on your way to hell if you do not repent. You go to Saudi Arabia and you kiss a black stone. My friends, you need to repent before it's too late. Before it's too late.
Baidu, I only see you touching those two corners. Yeah. It is talking about the black stone. I heard the messenger of Allah say, touching the black stone erases your sin. Mm. Touching the black stone takes your sin away.
Mm.
Touching the black stone makes you clean.
Mm.
Touching the black stone is a touching the black stone is going to take you to hell.
Yeah.
Touching the black stone, Allah is going to keep you in hell
Yeah. Okay.
Alright,
so should we summarize or? Yes? Okay.
So what the story is, what the Muslims are in court. And one of the things they are doing is kissing a stone with hoping that stone is going to atone for them. Hoping that stone is going to intercede for them. Hoping that stone is going to raise their sin. But they are forgetting something very important.
No, I don't. Because
that important thing is kissing that stone. Hoping that your sins will be forgiven is a shirk going to take you to hell and forever, according to your own teaching and according to Bible.
Where's the evidence?
That is sin as well.
Right. There's only one who can atone for your sin. It's God Himself. See, only God knows all the sins that you've committed. Only God knows all the laws that you've broken. But God, in the flesh, Jesus Christ, came to atone for your sin so that you wouldn't have to receive death. A black stone is an inanimate object. It can do nothing for you. Jesus Christ, the God of the universe, came and sacrificed His own life so that although you're a sinner, although you deserve hell, you can receive grace and salvation through His sacrificial death on the cross. Because only Jesus Christ, the Bible says, is the way, the truth, and the life. And only through Him can you get to heaven. And today I would say, turn away from idolatry, turn away from the lies of Islam, where it states, but if you kiss a black stone, that your sins can be atoned for. But come to the one, Jesus Christ. He alone has already paid the price. And all you have to do is receive the gift of life, of eternal life, through his death and His resurrection. Choose Jesus.
Choose Jesus.